Hello, my dear students. In this session, we are going to discuss about the exercise 3.2, that is in continuity with the linear equations in two variable. So, in the today's session, we are going to discuss the question number 1 of the 3.2. We will solve the part number 1 here, and then you have to solve the part 2 by yourself. And after that, we will cover with the question number 2 also. Before starting question number 2, there are some basics that need to be cleared for you. I will clearing that basics before starting question number 2. So let's start with this problem. This question basically deals with the linear equations only. See, from he has written from the pair of linear equations in the following problem and their solution graphically. We have to form the pair of linear equations from this problem and then we have to solve it graphically. So we read the statement. 10 students of class 10 took part in a mathematics quiz. If the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, find the number of boys and girls who took part in the quiz. So basically there are 10 students who have participated in the quiz competition, that is mathematics quiz, and the number of girls are 4 more than the number of boys. So definitely there is a something like number of boys and number of girls. So it is giving an indication that we have to take a variable only as the number of boys and number of girls. So solution of this problem will be like this. Let us consider the number of girls be x, similarly the number of boys be y. So according to question, as per the statement, we have total number of students, that is x plus y is equal to 10, that put in number 1. Similarly, we have, he told us that if the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, means number of girls 4 more than the number of boys. How much? Like boys are y, but girls are 4 more than boys, so y plus 4 will be there. So we will rewrite it, x minus y is equal to 4. So this is equation number 2 for us, right? So this is the pair of the linear equations which we got from this problem. Now we will solve it graphically. We will find out graphically by that how many boys were there and how many girls were there, right? So we have x plus y is equal to 10 and x minus y is equal to 4. So we will make a solution table for both the equations first of all. Then we will start with this the formation of graph. So in equation x plus y is equal to 10, x is equal to 10 minus y. So I will be making this equation we will make one box here. We will put y from our side. First of all, we take y as, I can say 4. I'm taking 4, 5, 6 the values of y, because if we subtract 4, 5, 6 from 10, we will get the values near about 4, 3, like this, 4, 5. So in this, we have to keep in mind that what values we are putting, that same result what we are getting. So we need to make a proper intervals, not like much gap should be there in the values. Okay, so like y is equal to 4. So x will be 10 minus 4, x is equal to 6. So if y is 4, x is 6. When y is 5, x is equal to 10 minus 5 and x is equal to 5. Similarly, when y is equal to 6, then x is equal to 10 minus 6, x is equal to 4. So 6 and 4, these values we got from the equation number 1. Similarly, for equation number 2, we will just again make a box here, table here, in which we will put the values. Now, again, it is 4 plus y. I will take the value of y from my side. Now we are going to add the y with 4. So we will take the smaller values of y so that the answer should be like, also if I put 4, then it will be 8. So we need to put the less values as compared to this. So I'll start with the 1, 2, 3. So if y is equal to 1, x is equal to 4 plus 1, that is 5. And if y is equal to 2, x is equal to 4 plus 2, that is 6. So 1 pe 5 hai or 2 is 6, and if y is equal to 3, then x is equal to 4 plus 3, that is 7. So these two tables, the oscillation tables we got for the two equations separately. Now we will plot these. Okay. Now we will be plotting these points on the graph. So basically before the formation of graph, we have to take that we must have three pairs of the values. So I'll just rewrite them here for our convenience. And we will put this table on the top. So 516273. Now we will erase this. Okay. So you don't mind that we are just using the quadrant 1 only. So no need to worry that this table is in between the quadrant. In actually, you're not supposed to make these tables in the on the graph. It should be separate. Only the plot the point should be plotted on the graph. So we will take the intervals. This is origin, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, x dash and y dash. So we have the maximum value here is up to 6 and 7. So we'll take up to the level of 8 on the both axes. So we'll start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Again here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 1, negative 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 and minus 8. Again we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. We need to extend it bit down, minus 7 and minus 8. Now we will plot these points, right? We will start with this table. We have x5 and y1. Where is x5? It is here. And y1 is here. So we will be having the point somewhere here. Point is here. So it is 5, 1. Next is 6, 2. So x is 6 and y is 2. When your x is 6, so y is 2, it will goes like this. And from here it will come down. So this is point 6, 2. Next is 7, 3. So 7 is here and 3 is here somewhere. So we will again go to this side and just take this point here. Because when we are not plotting it on graph, actually you can use scale also. Put scale here and make a line and put scale also this side. Just where they meet or intersect, that is the point where we need to plot. Alright. So this is the three points coming in the continuity. We can just join them as in the form of a line. So this is the line which we got from the first table. Now second, x is your 6 and y is 4. If x is 6 and y is 4, x is 6 and y is 4 somewhere here. Next is x is 5 and y is also 5. So it will go up to this point. Now x is 4 and y is 6. 4 from this point go to the top. X is 6, it is here. So we will take, so we can write the point also 6, 4, 5, 5 and 4, 6. So this is basically again a line. So now you have to extend this line. You can see that where this line is intersecting the previous line. So it is intersecting somewhere here. So if I take, so this is the point where both are meeting. Now that what we need, where the two lines meet each other on that particular point, this is the common point between the both the lines. So this is our solution basically. So from here we'll come down. It is a point 7 and 3. So x is 7 here and y is 3. So this is what we need basically, a solution of these two equations. So what we have to keep in mind while solving any equations graphically, that we have to draw the graph and we have to see that where these two lines intersect each other, whether they will intersect at any point, whether they will not intersect and whether they will overlap or we can say coincide. So in first and the third case, we will get the solution. So in this present problem, you are just going to make a pair of the problem and equation, and then you will start solving it graphically. In the graph, you need the solution table for the both the equations separately, and then you have to plot them. Where these two lines intersect each other, that will be the point which is the solution of these two equations. So here we got x equal to 7 and y is equal to 3. So therefore I can write it here also. Therefore the number of girls equal to 7 and number of boys is equal to 3. Those who participated in the math quiz. That is what is the question number 1. Now we will start with the question number 2. You have to keep a record of this and you have to solve the question number 2, the second part of this question by yourself. And I'll start with the question number 2 now. Before starting question number 2, I will be telling you something which you need to be, you have to listen it very carefully. See all of you, we have a basic form of linear equation or general form of linear equation, that is, if we having two equations, then how we write it basically. A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0 and A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. Now it depends that whether if we take the C1 to that side, definitely changes of sign will be there. So for this present time of thing, we will take it as a C1 and C2 this side only. And suppose if any equation is given to you in which this constant term is written that side, you can take it that side also. But make sure that both the constant should be in the right hand side of the equality, right? But here you take it as I have shown you, and you have to solve this equation like this only. See beta, you in this particular question, now he will be asking you that without solving, without solving, only we need to compare the ratios. So these are the ratios, basically which ratios we are talking about? The ratios of the coefficients of the variables. Now we have here A1, A2, that is the ratios of the coefficient of variable X. And again we have B1, B2 and C1, C2. And remember, you have to consider the sign, whatever the sign is with the variable, the coefficients, you have to take it, whether it is a negative or a positive. If it is a positive, it is understood, but if it is a negative, then you have to take, right? So in this particular problem, like these kinds of problem, you have to check. We will getting some certain outcomes from these ratios while comparing them. See, if case number one, if A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2. In this case, the two equations will only be having one solution. One means only one value of X and only one value of Y will be there. There is no other value for X and no other value for Y on which is the solution of these particular equations. So we call that it is having unique solution. Second thing, what about the graph which we will be making from this? The graph which will we get from this equation is in that two lines will always intersect each other if it is a unique solution. If it is a unique solution. And one more term I must add it now only. We also say these pairs of lines or equations, these pairs of equations are consistent. Presently there is no use of this term, but you will find this the use of this term later on in other questions. So remember, while saying this, you have to check. It is a unique solution and the pair of the lines will be lines which will be intersecting each other. Second case. Now in case, if A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 and not equal to C1 upon C2, means C1 and C2 is a separate or different. So in this case, we call there is no solution. And there is no solution also. And the what about the graph? The lines will be parallel. Lines will be parallel. And we also call it inconsistent. Third case is, if A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2, also equal to C1 upon C2, then it shows that there are many solutions. If we call it infinitely many solutions for this these equations, there is not a particular single value for that on which, you know, which is having x key, single value of x and single value of y. No, there are so many solutions for these two equations. So we call it infinitely many solutions, and the lines will be coinciding each other, means overlapping. Two lines will coincide each other. So also we call it consistent pair of equation. Consistent, inconsistent and consistent. So you have to remember these three cases, then only your question number 2, and further it is very beneficial for you. You have to remember it. So if while saying that first two ratios are not equal, you have directly to say that it is a unique solution, the lines will be intersecting and it is a consistent. But whatever is asked, just choose that only. If he is asking about the lines, just tell about the lines. If he is asking about the solution, tell about the solution, right? Similarly, in the second case, if a1 upon a2 n is equal to b1 upon b2 and not equal to c1 upon c2, then means it is no solution. If a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2, means infinitely many solutions. So in this case, the line will coincide each other, and here the lines are parallel and it is inconsistent and it is consistent. Any doubts in this, you can ask me, you can send me in as your message if you are not clear about this term, right? We will start with the next question, what we have been having. How we are solving this question now, see it. Other parts you have to solve by your own. See, you have to compare. On comparing both equations, this one, 1 and 2, with a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. So we got a1 is equal to 5, b1 is equal to minus 4, c1 is equal to 8, and a2 is equal to 7, and b2 is equal to 6, and c2 is equal to minus 9. So what we got from here, I'll just solve it that side. We have a1 upon a2 is equal to 5 upon 7, b1 upon b2 is equal to minus 4 upon 6, and c1 upon c2 is equal to 8 upon 9. So while looking on the first two ratios, we are finding that they are not equal. So a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. So it shows that the pair of equations, linear equations, will be having unique solution. But what he has asked? He has asked, on comparing the ratios, find out whether the lines representing the following pair of linear equations will intersect at a point or are parallel or coincident. So what do you say? Because it is now first category, so solution is unique and the lines will intersect at a point. So we will say it is a unique solution. Simple write down, unique solution. And second, the lines will intersect at a point. So this is what we have to check. For all the other parts, you have to check it and see it and compare the ratios and find out whether it is the lines are intersecting or parallel or coincident. Any doubts in this question or any further other parts, you can tell me by message or by a call, and we will come up with the next session by other questions, right? Thank you very much. Take care and stay safe. Thank you.